Hi students, I'm CA Anuj Jalota. This is in reference to CA final new course paper 5 SCMPE strategic cost management and performance evaluation. You will be knowing this particular thing as I've told you all in class that the theory portion in your exams will be around for 15 to 20 marks plus there will be one compulsory case study question. To counter these particular requirements, what we all have done, hum logo ne kya kiya hai? Ek theory book launch kiya hai that comprises of around 103 questions. Okay, this is your book one, fully colored book. And then we have book two, okay, that is completely a case study book. So this introductory lecture, I'm just trying to give you the information about our book one right now. That is book one, that is a theory book, okay. Now, whatever is the sequence in your module, I've maintained the same sequence over here. That is first. Second, I have divided entire chapters into questions. Apart from that, if there is any reference to your practical syllabus, I have given that reference also. Third, for each and every question, you have video encrypted lectures that will be given from our side. So, if any question you have slight of a problem, agar koi bhi question ke na thoda sa bhi dikkat hai, you can see the video lectures. Approximately every video lecture will be around of 8 to 10 minutes, nothing much. But after this, you will be completely thorough with each and everything jo aapke syllabus ke andar hai. Whatever is there in your syllabus is covered up through these particular theory books. Okay. Now, these have been prepared with a thinking in mind that you do not want to be spending much amount of time for theory. So in case you want to read it, you can read it. In case you want to watch the lectures, in lectures I have underlined each and every sentence and I have tried to explain the meaning of that. Although one thing for sure, the theory in this book will not be asked as it is. It will be forming part of the comments of many chapters and on many questions that will be asked in exams. So there is nothing to mug up. Yahan pe kuch mug up karne wali cheez kuch wo nahi hai. Just aap ek bar sare ke sare jo lectures hain wo dekh sakte hain. You can read this particular book. Should not take much amount of time. You will be thorough with the entire portion. This is the first book exclusively on theory that has been launched. This will be launched across India and in Mumbai bookstores on 10th of Jan. Across India will be launched through Amazon. Okay, you all can watch out for the links over here. And in Mumbai, it will be available in most of the bookstores. Okay, theory, if it was a problem for you, now it will not remain a problem. I've tried to cover up each and every question jo aa sakta hai in exams. Okay. After this, we will be having one sample lecture of question number one of chapter number one. What I have also tried to do, agar beech mein kuch yaad karne wala cheez hai, if there is anything to be remembered from your side, I have tried to make some keywords in few of the question that might help you to remember in case you are of that type who wants some kind of keywords. Okay. I hope you will take advantage of this. All the links that you require are either below this particular video or they will be coming on 10th of Jan. Okay. All the best guys. Take care. The lecture number one, that is chapter number one, question number one will be starting after this. Hi guys. We will start away with chapter number one. Introduction to strategic cost management. We'll be doing question number one of that in this. Now, this introduction and this chapter number one is basically all about what? This is introduction to your entire subject. What is strategic cost management all about? And how it is different from traditional costing environment. Okay. Whatever you all have done in IPCC, that was all revolving only around one single part, and that one single part was how to control the cost. Most of the traditional accountants always used to be thinking that the best way to run any business is to cut down your cost. You cut down your cost, businesses will do good. But that was a traditional thing. Today, those concepts are factually not possible. In fact, today, in case you want to do a good business, you want to do a profitable business, it is necessary to control the cost. I'm not saying it is not. But at the same time, you cannot be too much cost conscious, because being too much cost conscious will also destroy quality of the product. So you should always remember that in case you are doing a business, you are taking a risk. And in that risk, you got to be incurring more cost. Example, every day Flipkart spends so much amount of amount. When they spend, obviously doesn't mean it is waste of money. It gets business for them. Okay, so spending cost is not bad. But you should ensure that by spending the cost, you get good return. So what we all are starting away this chapter with, what is traditional cost management? What is the process of traditional cost management and what are the limitations of that? Let's read it. Question number one. What is traditional cost management? Discuss its disadvantages. So process first. Traditional cost management involves around allocation of cost and overheads to the production, largely on cost control and reduction and earn better profits. Now, what does this thing mean? It means that traditional accountants, traditional cost accounting only focused on one thing, how to find out true cost. Once you find out the cost, try to think that is that cost that you have incurred on a higher side or lower side. Try to recall all your questions of CA Inter. Try to recall any question that you will have done in CA Inter. Your aim was find out the cost of this job, find out the cost of this job. And once you have found out the cost, at the end of the year, compare them with standard cost. Okay. But such kind of a process might not be good because there is excessive focus on trying to only control cost. Second, it involves comparing actual cost with standard expectations. Okay. Typically budget or standard cost and analyzing the difference. A corrective action would be then taken to ensure future outcomes are within the budgeted outcomes. Try to think what you all have done in standard costing. Say might be in CF final also. Actually, that is also part of traditional cost management. At the end of the year, we try to find out variances. And then we will try to think why this cost is not matching with the standard cost. And then if it was higher, we learn a lesson from there. And then this lesson is used for future. Taki in future, we do not try to do the same mistakes that we all have done in past. So this is a process how your traditional cost management works. Okay, too much talking of cost reduction, too much talking of cost control, and basically everything focuses on have you controlled the cost or not. Now what are the disadvantages of it? First one, ignores competition, market growth and customer requirement. Now what does it mean? In costing, you try to recall most of your questions in IPCC. Focus was only around the company. Company has got some job. What is the cost? Has company incurred more cost or less cost? Visualize one thing. We should have incurred, say, 10 lakh rupees on marketing. We incurred 13 lakhs. Now, somebody might say, sir, variance will be 3 lakh rupees adverse. It is bad, but I still think sometimes that can be good also. Might be if you would not have incurred 13 lakh rupees of marketing cost, you would not have achieved the sales that you have. So somewhere or the other, we ignore whatever is happening outside the business. There is only a concern whatever is happening inside the business. We don't try to think what a customer wants. We try to think what we want to give. We have made a product. We want to sell the product. We find out its cost. We add our profit margin. In this entire process, where is the customer gone? Next. Too much reliance on accounting data. Try to think what you all have done in relevant costing with me. I used to tell you exactly the same thing. Accountants are useless. Because they are only trying to see some historical information, but history might not repeat itself every year. Whatever has happened, you can learn from there, but that thing might not happen in future all the times. Okay. So we are excessively focused on whatever is happening in our books of accounts, which we should not be. Your accounts should not be a technique for decision making. It will spoil your business in long run. Further, short run outlook. When you only focus on cost, frankly speaking, you are only trying to think how to do this year's business, how to try to be profitable in this month, not forever. You want to be profitable forever? Okay, be good. Have good practices. Have a product which is world class. Try to provide world class service. Try to ensure that you are always in ahead of comp. Now, all these particular factors do not come into old traditional accounting. Next. limited focus on review and improvisation. Now, we are only focused about one thing, whether costs have been controlled or not. See what is written over here. The expectations of modern customers are quite different. An excessive focus on cost reduction might destroy the quality of the product and services. Example, you only try to think. If suppose I generate some profit from your batch, I try to think next year I want to be having more profits. If I'm a traditional person, I will always like to think, let's cut down the cost, let's cut down the cost. How? How, sir? Cut down your books cost. How to cut down the cost? That's not possible. Sir, speak with the supplier. You negotiate with him. Perfect. I will do that. But that will help you to save to some extent, not very great extent. Sir, use cheaper quality of paper. When you try to do that, it destroys quality of your product. Honestly, next year my sales might fall down if I try to use some cheap quality of paper. Okay. So, we are not trying to think of improvements. We are not trying to thinking of making the better company. We are only trying to think how to reduce the cost. Fifth, excessive focus on cost reduction. I guess that we all have spoken also. Reactive approach. Reactive approach means for this year we all had planned something. We started with the year. At the end of the year something else happened. And then we try to take a corrective action for it. Example, material prices were higher. So our material price variance was adverse. So next year we try to think what we can do so that material price variance is not adverse. Now instead of thinking this on the first day, can't you all start to think like this? Let's try to estimate what will happen, say each and every month or each and every season if your raw material is say dependent upon nature. And then automatically in this case, try to ensure that you adhere to those things. This concept you all will learn with me in beyond budgeting. Okay, that is one of the chapters that are there. So basically this is all about let the worst happen. Okay, let the things happen. Let there be a loss. And then we'll try to learn lessons from there. A better way, try to estimate the future. Once you estimate the future, then if ever your estimation keeps on getting changed, you revise your estimates also. You revise your targets also. That will be a better way to be running the business. So this is fully a reactive approach, not a proactive approach. Okay, that was your question number one.